Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm doing a collab video with my friend Tarun Ashok about the video game history. And this is part two. If you yet haven't seen part one, please go do so. And don't forget to smash that like button and make that subscribe button green. So let's get started. In 1980, a missing slice of pizza inspires Namco's Toru Iwatani to create Pac-Man, which goes on sale in July 1980. That year, a version of Pac-Man for Atari 2600 becomes the first arcade hit to appear on a home console. 2 years later, Miss Pac-Man strikes a blow for gender equality by becoming the best-selling arcade game of all time. In 1981, video game fans go ape over Nintendo's Donkey Kong, featuring a character that would become world famous, Jumpman. Never heard of him? That's because he's better known as Mario, the name he took when his creator, Shigeru Miyamoto, makes him the star of a later game by Nintendo. In 1982, Disney taps into the video game craze by releasing the movie Tron, an arcade game featuring many of the contests from the movie, also becomes a hit. In 1983, multiplayer play takes a huge step forward with Dan Bunton's MULE. In the game, players compete to gather the most resources while saving their colony on the planet of Errata. In 1984, Russian mathematician Alexey Pajitnov creates Tetris, a simple but addictive puzzle game. The game leaks out from behind the Iron Curtain, and 5 years later, Nintendo bundles it with every new Game Boy. In 1985, the Nintendo Entertainment System, NES, revives an ailing United States video game industry 2 years after the Nintendo Corporation released it in Japan as Famicom. In 1986, the emerging educational software market leaps ahead with the introduction of the learning company's Reader Rabbit program. The educational computer business mushrooms with the introduction of CD-ROMs in the 1990s, but crashes with the rise of the internet. In 1987, it's a good year for fantasy role-playing games as Shigeru Miyamoto creates Legend of Zelda, SSI, wins the video game license for Dungeons and Dragons, and Sierra's Leisure Suit Larry gives players a different kind of adult role-playing game. In 1988, John Madden Football introduces gridiron realism to computer games, making this game and its many console sequels perennial bestsellers. In 1989, Nintendo's Game Boy popularizes handheld gaming. Game Boy is not the first handheld game. with interchangeable cartridges. Milton Bradley introduced Microvision 10 years earlier, but it charms users with its good gameplay, ease of use, and long battery life. In 1990, Microsoft bundles a video game version of the classic card game Solitaire with Windows 3.0. Millions of users who would not normally pick up a game console find they enjoy playing computer games. Solitaire becomes one of the most popular electronic games ever, and provides a gaming model for quick, easy to play casual games like Bejeweled. In 1991, Sega needs an iconic hero for its Genesis, known as Mega Drive in Japan, system, and finds it in Sonic the Hedgehog. Gamers, especially in the United States, snap up Sega systems and love the little blue guy's blazing speed and edgy attitude. In 1992, Westwood Studios' Dune 2 establishes the popularity of real-time strategy games that require players to act as military leaders, deploying their sources and forces on the fly in order to defeat opponents. In 1993, concern about bloodshed in games such as Mortal Kombat prompts United States Senate hearings on video game violence. The controversy riles the industry and prompts the creation of the video game rating system. Ironically, that same year, the game Doom popularizes first-person shooters. In 1994, Blizzard releases Warcraft. Orcs and Humans, a real-time strategy game that introduces millions of players to the legendary world of Azeroth. In 1995, Sony releases PlayStation in the United States, selling for $100 less than Sega Saturn. The lower price point, along with the arrival of Nintendo 64 in 1996, weakens Sega's home console business. When Sony PlayStation 2 debuts in 2000, it becomes the dominant home console, and Sega exits the home console business. In 1997, machine triumphs over man as IBM's supercomputer chess program Deep Blue defeats world champion Garry Kasparov in a match. In 1998, Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time transports players to the richly imagined world of Hyrule, full of engaging characters, thought-provoking puzzles, and the most memorable musical instrument to ever appear in a video. In 2000, Will writes The Sims models real life. It is not the first simulation game. Utopia on Intellivision in 1982, Peter Molyneux's Populous in 1989, and Sid Meier's Civilization in 1991, and Wright's own SimCity in 1989 preceded it. But it becomes the best-selling computer game ever and the most popular game with female players. Now I hand it over to Tarun Ashok, who will be continuing.
Thank you, Aditya, for passing it on to me. And now let's continue. In 2001, Microsoft enters the video box game market with Xbox and hit games like Halo Combat Evolved came. 4 years later, Xbox 360 gains millions of fans with its advanced graphics and seamless online play. In 2002, the US Army releases America's Army video game to help recruit and communicate with a new generation of electronic gamers, and the Woodrow Wilson International Center for Scholars launches the Serious Games Initiative to encourage the development of games that address policy and management issues. In 2003, Valve energizes PC gaming with its release of Steam. The digital distribution platform allows players to download, play, and update games. In 2004, Nintendo maintains its dominance of the handheld market with the Nintendo DS, an easy-to-use portable gaming system packed with two processors, two screens, multiplayer capabilities, and a stylus for the touchscreen. Great games like Super Mario Kart DS help too. Microsoft's Xbox 360 brings high-definition realism to the game market, as well as even better multiplayer competitions on Xbox Live and popular titles such as Alan Wake. In 2006, Nintendo WII gets gamers off the couch and moving with innovative motion-sensitive remotes. Not only does Nintendo make gaming more active, it also appeals to millions of people who never before liked video games. In the year 2007, grab your guitar, microphone, bass, or drums and start playing Rock Band. That's what millions of would-be musicians did with Harmonix's hit title. In 2008, 4 years after its release, World of Warcraft surpasses 10 million subscribers, making it the most popular massively multiplayer online or MMO game ever. MMOs create entire virtual universes for players and redefine how we play, learn, and relate to one another. In the year 2009, social games like Farmville and mobile games like Angry Birds shake up the games industry. Millions of people who never would have considered themselves gamers now while away hours playing games on new platforms like Facebook and the iPhone. In 2010, the indie game movement comes of age with the tremendous popularity of Minecraft, the addictive brick-building game from Swedish developer Marcus Persson. In 2011, Skylanders: Cyprus Adventurer becomes the first augmented reality hit by letting players place plastic figures on a portal of power to zap characters into the game. 2 years later, Disney Infinity joins the ranks of toy video games hybrids. In the year 2012, crowdfunding site Kickstarter enables game creators to raise millions of dollars to produce new and experimental play platforms such as the OUA console and Oculus Rift. In 2013, Gone Home, The Last of Us, and Papers, Please usher in a new wave of mature video game stories that comfort players with tough emotional choices in ethically complex worlds. In 2014, free-to-play becomes dominant business model as blockbusters such as Crossfire, Clash of Clans, World of Tanks, and even Kim Kardashian Hollywood achieves sales in the hundreds of millions of dollars through microtransaction payments for in-game items and premium content. in the year 2015, 1 year after being acquired by Amazon online video streaming service Twitch, fuels the growth of esports. 36 million viewers watched the League of Legends World Championship, rivaling the surpassing viewership of some of the most popular athletic events in the world. In the year 2016, player hunts for virtual creatures like Pikachu and Horsia in the real world with Niantic's free-to-play hit Pokemon Go. It's the gaming sensation of the summer, and commenters debate whether it is just a fad or represents a bright future for augmented reality. In 2017, Nintendo Switch introduces the first hybrid mobile home video game console into a game market dominated by smartphones and tablets. The innovative system allows players to take hit games like Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild, and Super Mario Odyssey with them wherever they go. In 2018, Microsoft's Xbox Adaptive Controller makes gaming on Xbox One consoles and Windows 10 PCs more accessible for players with limited mobility. Its two large programmable buttons and 19 jacks empower players to connect additional switches, joysticks, and other assistive devices to customize the way they play their favorite game. In the year 2019, millions of players tune into watch a virtual asteroid destroy the map of Epic Games' massively popular online battle royale game Fortnite. The game, which earned a staggering $2.4 billion in 2018, respawned 2 days later with a new map dubbed Fortnite Chapter 2. Please like, share, and subscribe, and see you guys next time.